dependent versus independent variables. So now we are going to discuss the differences between both of the variables. In our right side, you can see a graph which we can explain further that what is the relation between an age and a height. So dependent variables are like an effect and independent variables are like a cause. So obviously there is a relation between a cause and an effect. So cause is independent and effect is dependent. So obviously cause can be manipulated, but the effect can be measured. The independent variables are like a cause and you can manipulate the cause, but you cannot manipulate the effect. It is always be measured. Okay, so obviously in our daily life we can manipulate it independent variables, but we can measure dependent variables. So this is a example. Independent variables is like a variable that is change, so like amount of water, and dependent variables that can affect by the change, like size of the plant, number of leaves, living or death. Like more water you can give, so more the plant grows, more the leaves grow. So now we can tell you the definition. Independent variable is a factor in an experiment that the researcher intentionally manipulates or changes to observe its effect. It is considered the cause or reason for an observed effect. Any changes in the dependent variables are hypothesized to be directly caused by variations in the independent variable, while the dependent variable is what the researcher measures to see if the changes as a result of the manipulation of the independent variable. It represents the outcome or effect in an experiment. So the changes in the dependent variable are considered to be dependent on the variations in the independent variable. So this I hope this definition explains the difference between both of them. Another example. So experiment is thus room temperature effect the test score. Independent variable is temperature and the dependent variable is your result. So obviously it's very commonly experienced thing that if there is a very heated environment, then you have a more sweating and you will be less performing. And if there is an air conditioner room and you are relaxed and you are easy to write your exam, then obviously your mind is relaxed, you are at peace, then you can score more score. Okay, so this is a very common example that we can see. And then another example. So independent variable is like the R test score impacted by the amount of time spent sleeping the night before a test. So the answer is yes. Independent variable is a sleep that you get before your exam, and dependent variable is your score because your mind is fresh. So another examples. Research question is, what is the effect of the blood pressure level due to salt content? Dependent variable is blood pressure level and independent variable is increase or decrease the salt in the body. Obviously, if you increase the salt, then you will have more high blood pressure. So there is a direct relation between blood pressure and a usage of salt. Then is students performing affected by the usage of mobile? So obviously, more mobile usage, then there will be a less performance of students. So there is an inverse relation between mobile usage and the students' performance. So, do plants grow faster with the application of natural or synthetic fertilizer? So, independent variable is like a rate of growth of plants and independent is type of fertilizer. Obviously, if you give the more quality fertilizer, then the plants will grow. And then we have another example. The dependent variable responds to or depends on the independent variable. Obviously, the dependent means that you have to depend on another, and independent means that you have not dependent on any other thing. So independent is like a amount of light plant receives, and the dependent variable is la plant health. So in my previous slide I told you that independent variable is like a cause, it can control, it can graph on x-axis, and the dependent variable is like an effect, it can be measured on the graph on y-axis. So obviously more amount of water, more amount of light you can give to your plant, so the plant health will be positively affected. So there is a direct relation between the amount of light or the amount of water or the amount of care you give to a plant to the plant health. The plant will grow more if you care more, obviously. So this is a graph which tells you that there are two axes, okay? So there is the x-axis and there is the y-axis. So in the x-axis there is an independent variable, or in a y-axis there are the dependent variables. So another example, distance in miles versus the cab fare in dollars. So obviously the more distance you travel, the more fare you have to give. So say the direct relation between distance and the amount of fare you have to give to a cab driver or any other rickshaw or van driver that you are traveling. Then another example, time versus speed. So obviously the speed is dependent on the time, is dependent on the speed. How? Okay, if there is a more speed, if you faster than the, there is less time. Then age versus time, age versus height. Obviously in the height is dependent on the age. If there is a more age, then your height will grow. Okay, then at some point your height will stop. Okay, so then the types of the treatment level and the dependent variable is the blood pressure. So number one, low dose of the new medication. So what will be the dependent variable? Like there will be no change in the blood pressure. Or high dose of the new medication, so the blood pressure is lowered. And number third is placebo, so no change in blood pressure. So basically this is an example of a blood pressure and a medicine. So independent variable is type of treatment. It can be either medicine or your lifestyle changes or the foods that you are taking, or there will be a drips or any surgery. And the dependent variable is a blood pressure. So the more care you give, the more blood pressure will be controlled. So another treatment is the group A is treatment with active medication and group B is treatment with inactive medication. So dependent variable is participant response. That what will be the response of the participant depending upon if you are giving him medicine or you are not giving him medicine. Then how to identify the dependent variable? So is this variable manipulated by the researchers? If the answer is yes, so it is independent variable, and no, so the dependent variable. And does this variable cause an outcome? So if the answer is yes, so it will be independent variable, and if the answer is no, so it is dependent variable. And is this variable the result of another variable? So obviously yes for dependent variable and no for independent variable. So now there is another example. Independent variable affects the dependent variable, obviously. So investigator manipulates the independent variable to change the outcome. So the last example is dependent variable is asthma, and what are the independent variables? Like there is a patient who has asthma. So what will be the reasons? It would be his weight, height, intensity, substance exposure, and medical history. So these are the independent variables that will affect the asthma patients. Like what is your weight? If you are more on the obesity side, then obviously you will be have more asthma. And if you substance exposure, like there will be there is some virus or infections, or are you allergic to anything? So thank you.